timekeeper on the bell is Chris O'Connor, and upon the sound of the bell, the third man in the ring is our referee, who will also score this contest should it go the distance. Introducing from Liverpool, Mark Lyson. Boxing out of the blue corner with a perfect fight record. 8 visits to the ring as a boxer, 8 victories on the scales at 10 stone 2 pounds, and tonight wearing the black shorts trimmed with yellow. Scales at 10 stone 2 pounds, 10 visits to the ring as a professional boxer, 10 victories to his credit. This evening he's wearing the black shorts trimmed with purple and silver, and boxes out of Atherton, Greater Manchester. Introducing the undefeated Super lightweight contest, this one scheduled for 8 and 3 minute rounds of boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, somebody's O is about to go.
Here we go then.
Second time.
Billy the Kid, Ashley Peyton. Two unbeaten fighters.
Yeah, whenever two unbeaten fighters clash, it always brings a little bit extra out of both of them, doesn't it? Peyton 10-0. Bilal Rehman 8-0. Something's got to give. Like, both got fairly unique sort of styles, haven't they, as well, Luke?
Yeah, you know what you're going to get from Bilal. You look at him, he's very tall for the weight, very rangy. But Peyton's a good boxer in his own right as well. It'll be interesting to see how the styles gel tonight.
Big step up for them both, you know. Bilal's not beaten a fight with a winning record since his debut, and Ashley's never been in against a guy with a winning record, so both fellas have just skipped that intermediate stage and were jumping straight into a real challenge. Well, a credit to both guys for doing it as well.
Yeah, I was going to say, fair play to them both for taking this challenge. And
good right hand from Bilal. He's freakishly tall, isn't he, for a light welterweight? I think he's 6'1".
Yeah, and he was telling me at the weigh-in yesterday that he made the weight easy. He was walking around on fight week, all week, bang on the weight, saying on the weigh-in day he had good food, and he was still bang on the weight, so it's not like he struggles with the weight at all.
We've seen different sides to Bilal, haven't we? You know, we remember that spectacular knockout of Billy Parker a couple of years ago now. Beautiful uppercut. We've also seen him box safety first and just get the decision, haven't we? And Peyton can be... It's hard to pin down his style. I think Peyton doesn't know what he's going to do at the time. I think it just comes naturally. So we've seen both guys operating different styles. It should mean we can both adapt to the other one the longer this goes on, I think.
Bilal's just trying to use his height, isn't he? Just staying a little bit out of the pocket for Peyton. But then Peyton's head movement's excellent. That was a nice shot on the way in. But then Peyton came back with his own.
That is going to be the big test, isn't it, for Peyton? It might, in fact, it will decide the outcome of a fight. If Peyton can't get past that lead hand of Bilal, if he can't close the distance, Bilal's going to win. That's what Peyton has got to do. And maybe his unorthodox way of boxing is going to help him do that. Maybe, you know, he might just find a route to get inside. He's already just tried an uppercut there, hasn't he? Interesting first round.
Yeah, it's one of them. I think Bilal will get that round. A little bit busier using his reach well, but Peyton seems to warm into that one, didn't he? And he was getting better towards the end of it. Hashtag VIP Boxing Live on Twitter, let us know what you think. Comment on the Facebook stream as well, we'll get it all read out for you.
Second round, a couple of little bumps under Peyton's eyes. I don't think it's much, but I think that was just while he got accustomed to Bilal's range and style. As Luke said, he seemed to be just getting to grips with things at the end of a round.
I know Bilal's been sparring Jack Castro in the build-up to this. Good pedigree sparring that he's had.
He's landing the jab very too easily, really. Well, Peyton's going to have to work out a way around this. Nice, elusive work there from Bilal. Just skipped out of range, didn't he? If you let him get into his groove, he'd become a nightmare to fight.
Fell in with a little bit with that one, Bilal. Doesn't need to do that. A little bit of sustained pressure here from Bilal. Landed a few shots then. Just working off that jab.
Yeah, I think Peyton's really struggling to work this out at the moment. Bilal's got his range, making Peyton pay for falling in, making him pay for missing. It's becoming a bit of a frustrating time. Ashley will have known this was going to happen though, you know, he'll have known it was going to take a bit of getting used to, but he's just hurt with a right hand there. And Bilal's realised it as well. Left to the body, Bilal digs in.
Yeah, he's really putting the pressure on now with Peyton with his back to the ropes.
Beautiful. Peyton's hurt again.
Yeah, it's that right arm that's doing the job. It's yeah, right.
Raymond's got his range perfect and Peyton just can't find a way through it at the moment. Something drastic's got to change.
Yeah, and Mark Lyson's having a little look at this.
I think he needs to find some success quick or need some words of wisdom from his corner, because if he carries on like this, Bilal's just having his way really.
Well, that's been quite clever, isn't he? When Peyton does manage to close that gap, he just holds on, makes the referee separate them, and then gets back to that jab.
I'm not sure why Bilal's switched stances there. You know, the right hand's been his punch. On the plus side for Ashley, he's got through the round. You know, he's took two flush right hands and made it through, but something's got to change, I think. Just having a look at him in his corner. He looks okay, doesn't he? He looks cleared eyes. He was listening to what he's been told. He's just got to deal with the problem. Bilal, on the other hand, couldn't look calmer.
But equally, it's now in the back of the referee's head. Look, Peyton's been hurt a couple of times there, and that's the big thing for Bilal now. If he starts landing clean again, then he's going to have a look. And Bilal will be growing in confidence, and like you said, once he gets into that style of his, he's a nightmare. Gave us a little nod as well, Bilal. He told me it'd be easy night's work yesterday.
what's a very busy stream. Lots of you watching tonight. Hope you're enjoying this. You know, sometimes as good as it is to watch a back and forth battle, it's also really good to watch a fighter perform to a different level, isn't it? And watch a really good performance. And so far, that's what you've seen from Bilal Rehman.
Bilal landed a left hook earlier in that round, and it looked like Peyton's leg stiffened a little bit, but I think it was just the way he was stood. On the camera, it looked like he'd been hurt a lot more than he had.
I'd like to see Peyton just stick a double jab into Bilal and follow it in behind, just close that distance. You know, pouring with one shot, he's getting countered. I think he's got a punching combination here to just narrow this distance.
Yeah, and one thing is, when Bilal throws that right hand, he falls in a little bit. And if Peyton can avoid that and then get back on the inside, that's where he wants to be.
This is like disaster territory for Peyton, just at arm's reach. This is where he can't be.
Lovely
just
right
looked to counter with a left hook there, didn't he? Just as you said, as Bilal fell in with a right hand, he just looked to counter that left hook.
It's been a good performance from Bilal so far, though. We could have told you what Bilal's game plan would have been before the fight, but he's sticking to it perfectly, it's working. But just so that's where Peyton wanted to be, on the inside.
What I like about what Bilal's doing, we know he could have done this, but his actual spite in his punches
exactly.
As well. He's not playing it safety first, is he? But Peyton's still there, you know, and he is getting closer now. He is making Bilal get on the back foot.
I'm not sure about this southpaw stance that Bilal's adopting. He seems to have, like he is now, the success with that right hand coming straight through the middle.
Just signs him at last minute, but a bit of a sting had gone out of Bilal's work.
Yeah, Peyton was starting to walk through a few more shots then, whereas in the opening two rounds, if one of those right hands would have landed, Peyton felt it, but seems to be walking through it a little bit better now.
Yeah, as we said, you know, although the first round especially was bad for Peyton, the positive was that he was still in there. And there was just signs there for the last minute that he was being able to push Bilal back. I don't think we can say the tide had turned, but there were signs that Ashley could get a foothold in this now.
But equally, we're into the fourth round now. This is halfway, and that's the problem with fights like this. Peyton's lost the first three rounds. Yes, he's looking to get back into it, but he can't afford to waste too much time.
Tom Farrell's watching, saying, you know, Bilal's winning, fading though. Just watching what's going on in his division. Just took an interesting turn in the final stage of that round, this fight. And see if Peyton can just capitalise on what he managed to achieve.
Yeah, Peyton seems to be able to walk in a little bit more now, doesn't he? He's getting a little bit closer.
Oh, beautiful. Beautiful straight left hand with Bilal as a southpaw, Luke.
Love, lovely shot from Bilal. Peyton's up. I think he's okay. I think it was more of a flash knockdown, but we'll see the effects of that now.
Yeah, we were saying we didn't understand why he was turning southpaw. There's our answer.
What do we know, eh?
Tremendous right. Peyton's got to go into survival mode now. All that good work's undone as another big right hand.
Yeah, if Bilal can pick a few punches in, it'll be all right here. He'll get the win. That's good from Bilal, just taking a little step back, composing himself and then going again.
His coach, Joe Pennington's waving him in. There's the right again. Peyton stands up to this one though. And again, what a credit to him. You know, he looked hurt from that straight left, as he was knelt on the ground, but he's battled his way back again, hasn't he?
Yeah, and when he got up, Bilal landed with another right hand, and his face looks hurt, like when a fight was about to go, but he's stuck in there and he looks okay now.
He's operating in a danger zone constantly though, isn't he? You know, at any time he's just at the perfect range for Bilal to put the straight right, or as we just saw with a knockdown, the straight left right through the guard. He's got to get closer.
But again, we're coming towards the end of this round and he's still in there. We've seen fighters dominate before and then tire towards the end, haven't we? And it can be changed like that. That's the main thing. Peyton's still in there, still fighting. Ten seconds left of the round.
Yeah, just get to the end of his round, Peyton again. Big round for Bilal Rehman. Peyton needs a knockout now, doesn't he?
Yeah, you think so. And we were saying Bilal's punch power was fading a little bit.
Yeah, he just relaxed into it. Just shoulder dropped, came through, and as easy as you like, powerful, powerful shot. You know, Bilal has been asking for fights like this for a while now, hasn't he? He got fed up of fighting the journeyman. He's nagged Steve, he's nagged Joe Pennington to make for fights like this, and he's living up to it.
And the message from Bilal's corner there was clear. They want straight shots. That's what's winning him the fight. Also, he needs to do now.
Don't forget, share this link around. There's no other boxing on tonight, and you're seeing two unbeaten kids putting it all on the line here. It's a good fight. Tell the people, all your boxing fans you know, to watch this. Bilal's got Joe Pennington and Dave Murray watching very closely from the corner. Dave, who we operate out the same gym. Dave looks after ruthless Ryan Doyle, who's going to have a big fight in October on the Anthony Crawler bill. Joe Pennington looks after fighters like William Warburton, who you saw earlier.
Curtis Gargano.
But Bilal's his hope for titles, and so far Bilal's not disappointing tonight. Peyton just sticking back with a left jab there though.
Yeah, Peyton's still very much in this fight. Bilal looks to be having a little breather in there now, doesn't he? He's just moving around the ring.
Yeah, he's put a lot of energy in for four rounds and dominated, and Ashley's still there. as we said before, just as the fight started, Louis, when you get two unbeaten British guys, it does bring something extra out of both people. And so far, we've seen that Bilal's raised his level of performance, and we've seen just how much Ashley Peyton wants this.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's still a lot of time in this fight left. It's by no means a foregone conclusion yet.
Bilal just measuring, just got that right hand cocked, just measuring it, and there it was, it landed. I can't help but think that when Peyton's team were putting together plans A, B and C, that being behind entering the final couple of rounds must have been something that they'd considered like a likelihood, and he would have to grit his teeth and come through this. Does look a bit despondent as he goes back to his corner, Ashley Peyton. Bilal looks a little bit tired, but has everything in hand now. It's his fight to lose, isn't it?
Yeah, a few people on the Facebook stream are talking about a little second win for Peyton.
Round six, and Ashley Peyton must surely know now that he needs a knockout to win. And he can't just rely on Bilal tiring, can he? He's got to produce something himself. Problem is, he's not a huge puncher.
He's just got to put some sustained pressure on Bilal now, hasn't he? And then see what comes from that, see if he gets any openings.
Gets there with the right hand, Peyton. Bilal just back to popping that jab. But he's operating at a much closer quarters now, isn't he, all the time. He's just keeping that constant pressure on Bilal. He's just got that extra 6 inches closer. It's making all the world a difference.
Yeah, it's meaning that Bilal can't get as much pop in his punches, and Peyton could land some of his own. It's exactly what he needs to do now.
It's taken 5.5 rounds, but it's finally becoming an Ashley Peyton sort of fight.
Bilal's just got to be careful there when he's holding, hasn't he? Because he's pushing Peyton down like that there.
Yeah, he's started looking to referee. You know, if Peyton's got enough left here, this could close up over the last couple of rounds. Well, Bilal still looks nice and sharp, but a little bit of snap definitely has left his work, hasn't it?
Yeah, you can see that Peyton's able to walk through a few more shots now.
And he just seems to have a burst of energy, Peyton, doesn't he? You know, he looked a lot more involved in the fight now. He's up on his toes. Again, I don't think we can save a tide's turn, but Peyton's got himself a foothold in the fight again, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. And I don't know, Bilal's not having as much pop behind those punches. He's working well, Peyton, and that was exactly the round he needed. He needs to keep doing that now. Keep the pressure on for the final 6 minutes of the fight and see what happens. Could play a little factor in this. If Bilal can start landing that, instead of pushing Payton's head down, if he can land an uppercut, that'll make a world of difference.
It will. Peyton has answered well, but he's just come out and stood right at punching range for Bilal again, hasn't he? You know, he must know now there's only one way he can do this, and it isn't to stand there. He's got to close that distance and get inside. He managed to do it in patches in the sixth. But 30 seconds have gone by in his seventh, and he's just stood at range.
You just got to be busy now, Peyton. He's got to really go for this. I think Peyton's waiting for that opportunity when Bilal throws to then counter him, but I think Bilal's realised that and he's just not throwing.
Bilal's punch output's dropped dramatically in this round, hasn't he? But oh, just as I say that, he just puts the best piece of work for a couple of rounds in.
It's a lovely straight right hand that landed.
Yeah, hurt Peyton again, didn't he? He's just got that extra burst of class. Rehman will be satisfied with that little burst of work, won't he? You know, it's the most eye-catching piece of action in the round. All Peyton's efforts again, all just really undone by one short, sharp combination.
Yeah, and little stints like that win you the round, don't they? It's the memorable thing from the round.
That uppercut you were looking for, Luke.
He's just cocking that right hand now, isn't he? Ready to throw it.
There's a famous right uppercut that flattened Billy Parker a couple of years ago, and he's looking to land it again on Ashley Peyton. Left up there from Bilal. And he just puts a stare on Peyton as the round ends. He knows there's one to go. It's all in his hands now.
I mean, if you're Bilal now, you've got to be sensible about it, close out this fight. If you're Peyton, you've got to go for this. Here we go then, final round of this contest, first title fight for both men. It looks like Bilal will be going home with that belt tonight, but you never know.
Second half of the eighth, final round.
Yeah, both men have given it their all, haven't they? If Peyton is going to win this, he can't stand there. We've said it numerous times now. You know, he's got to commit everything he's got left to getting onto Bilal's chest and letting those hands go. You know, if we're fighting here, Bilal's going to be comfortable, isn't he? He can use that jab and just dominate proceedings. Oh, and there's a right hand up. Was that a punch on the break, Luke?
It looked like it to me.
I thought it got called break, and we've got no replays here. I think it got called break, and Bilal landed a right hand, but referee Mark Lysons called a knockdown. It's a controversial moment, isn't it? Nonetheless, you know, it is counted as a knockdown. I don't think it'll have a great effect on the scoring. Peyton now, he must just commit everything he's got.
That right hand hurt him there.
Dramatic ending. Bilal had the fight in his hands anyway, but he's put a real exclamation mark on that, hasn't he, Luke?
Yeah, there's some question marks about the first knockdown. The second one, fantastic shot, ended the fight. I think Peyton still had that on his mind though, didn't he? You could see he was still talking to the referee about it.
I'm just watching a replay there of the first knockdown. The fighters did get tangled up and it did look like a break was called. And just as Peyton stepped back, he did get caught with the right hand but put him over. And, you know, he won't be happy with that. There's no doubt about the second one though. Fantastic win for Bilal Rehman. It's going to put him right in the mix for some other big fights at 140 pounds. You know, he's demanded fights like this. He's gotten the opportunity, he's grasped it with both hands. By far the best performance of his career. Peyton kept trying, kept coming, but he could never quite make his style tell, could he, Luke? He was constantly fighting in the danger zone and got made to pay and pay. He showed guts, he showed heart, but Bilal just had that extra little bit of class.
Yeah, and Peyton will be back, there's no doubt about that. He's putting a good account of himself tonight. Bilal's just a better man on the night.
Big fight in the future, you know, Ryan Mulcahy, area champion. We've got Bilal Rehman, he's going to be chasing Mulcahy, isn't he? You know, he's going to want that fight.
Yeah, and there'll be some big news over the next few weeks. We've been hinting at it all night, we're not going to give anything away, but if Billy wants it, there's another big fight on the way for him.
And that would be something of a mini super fight in the Northwest. You know, Ryan Mulcahy, very talented guy from Liverpool. Bilal Rehman, looking apart from Manchester.
I'm sure you agree, our two professional boxers have just delivered a great bout of boxing. I think everybody should just put their hands together and show their appreciation for both of their efforts. Our timekeeper Chris O'Connor ringside records an official end to the contest at 1 minute 48 seconds of round number 8. Referee Mark Lyson stops the contest in his professional opinion. Ashley Peyton was in no position to defend himself, therefore declaring you winner and still undefeated as a professional boxer from Rochdale, Bilal, Billy the Kid, Rehman. And the steward in charge from the British Boxing Board of Control, Sally Say, now presents the British Classic Super Lightweight Challenge belt to our victor. Once again, Rochdale's undefeated Bilal, Billy the Kid, Rehman.
So there you go, Bilal Rehman comes through with the biggest test of his career. Eighth round stoppage of the previous unbeaten Ashley Peyton. That's not the end of a title action here on VIP Boxing TV. We've got Ben Sheedy against Alistair Warren. Promises to be the fight of the night. Both guys can punch. Both guys going to come to win. Ben Sheedy unbeaten, looking better and better every time. Alistair Warren isn't just going to come to lie down. Alistair Warren usually leaves it all in the ring. Hope you're enjoying the action tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's share the Facebook stream. Respect between our two boxers. But I've had a nice hand as well, please, for our very gallant runner up there. And this is Ashley Peyton.
Share the Facebook stream. Share the links about.
Next time in the ring, he'll be announced as the still